Good Saturday evening, everybody. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe. Here's a look at your updated forecast. So we have the heat. It's only going up from here. Same thing with the humidity. And then overnight tonight, this evening and through the overnight, there is a chance of some strong, maybe even severe thunderstorms moving through primarily the northern portion of the state. That's where we have actually the highest risk. And it looks like the main risk, the threat, will be for damaging winds. We'll likely get a line of storms that forms north of the border, and then we'll move across primarily Coos County, maybe into northern Carroll and Grafton County. It may even reach the Lakes region too during the early part of the overnight hours. Not expecting severe in the southern part of the state. It looks like this line should develop and then fade as it moves from the north to the south across the state. But it's something we're watching very carefully because this could contain damaging wind gusts. So right now, nothing really of substance happening. We've had a few downpours moving through Coos County, but a quick glance up to the north, and there is obviously some unsettled weather. There's a disturbance up here, and eventually this is going to sag to the south. It'll feed off of the heat and the moisture over us and could bring in some strong to severe thunderstorms. Now let me show you how it works. So the timing of this looks like it should be after dark in the north country. Some of our computer models have it a little bit sooner, but watch what happens. There's that line, and this thing, I gotta be honest with you, looks pretty nasty. We could have damaging wind gusts as this line, or this Boeing segment we call it, basically comes right down shooting out of Quebec during the evening and maybe even as late as midnight in the northern part of the state, and then basically dies as it moves down toward the Lakes region. So I think the worst of it would be in the north country anywhere from say 6 p.m. to about midnight, maybe just after that. I know it's a big time frame, but the computer model's having a little hard time figuring out when that would move through. Tomorrow is quieter, though much warmer. In fact, we hiked the temperatures up a few degrees, except at the coast, where temperatures will actually be at their highs in the afternoon, in the early afternoon, and then they'll fall back into the 70s by the later afternoon. High temperatures today in the 90s in many spots. Today was day two in Concord and in Manchester. The other big difference tomorrow will be the humidity. It goes way up into the 70s, into the oppressive zone. So if you thought it felt really humid now, just wait. Tomorrow into Monday and Tuesday, we get a prolonged period where we get this heat and the humidity. Both of those two things combined on Sunday afternoon will make it feel like the triple digits in some spots. Look at this. Now, I think 105 might be a little bit much, but there certainly will be areas, especially in southern and in western New Hampshire, where there's a heat advisory, where we could have feel like temperatures in the hundreds. Ouch. Stay cool. Overnight tonight, really warm. Look at overnight temperatures in the 70s from Manchester down into Nashua and in Salem. And then you see the heat is really on, particularly in the Monadnock region and Upper Valley. Look at Keene. That's the actual air temperature. Maybe 99 tomorrow. A bit cooler, though, as I mentioned, at the seacoast. That's going to be the place to go. I'm sure a lot of people out there already. The beach forecast tomorrow. So you see that the high temperature actually happens in the morning or midday, and then we fall back into the 70s. So it'll be a great beach day, no matter where you go. Even inland areas, of course, will be hot, but great place to cool down at the lakes. Slightly cooler, if you can call 90 cooler on Monday. Then Tuesday, chance of some scattered thunderstorms, but that may be the hottest day in the upper 90s. And then for the 4th of July, sunshine with temperatures in the mid 90s. Again, Thursday, another hot one. Finally, storms will roll through on Friday, and that will signal some cooler, less humid air. There you go. Temperatures in the 80s by next Saturday should be the end of this heat wave.